What if someone told you your salary is in the 70th percentile? Is that a good thing or is it a bad thing? What information does percentile actually tell us? And what's the difference with percentage? That's what we're going to take a look at in a second. We're also going to take a look at how you can make meaningful percentile calculations in Excel. Let's start with the definition. You just got your test results for an advanced Excel exam, and you scored 80%. You're told that this was in the 70th percentile. What does this mean? Is this good or bad? This means that 70% of exam results were below yours, and 30% of the results were better than your result, which was 80%. When we describe percentile, we use the word percentage, but they're two separate things. So percentage is the mathematical value that you see out of a total of 100, whereas percentile is used to display the position or the rank of something by comparing that number to other numbers. It shows you the percentage of values that are found under the specific value, whereas with percentage, it's a means of comparing, but it's based on a single case. Percentage is shown by the percentage sign, whereas percentile is denoted by TH, so you have the 25th percentile. Let's look at this calculation in Excel. We have here a list of average salaries by country for a software developer, and we want to figure out what's the 25th percentile. To do that, we're going to start off with the percentile function, but notice we have different versions. So there is the original percentile function, which is still there for compatibility purposes, but later we got two different versions of this, percentile INC for inclusive and percentile X for exclusive. The more common one that's used is the INC version, but I'm also going to show you later the different results we get if we use the X version. This only needs two arguments. The first one is the array, so that's the set of numbers that you want to compare it to. So I'm just going to highlight this, and I'm going to press F4 to fix the reference. Next, for K, we enter the percentage. In this case, it's 0.25. Now, when I close the bracket and press Enter, I get the salary value of the 25th percentile. This means that 25% of the salaries here are less than this, and 75% are above this value. Now, I want to be able to pull this down, so I'm just going to input the percentages right here. And let's update that last argument to reference this cell and pull this down. Okay, so if you earn $64,201, your salary is in the 75th percentile, which means that 75% of the salaries listed here are below this salary. Now, what if you wanted it the other way around? So what if you wanted to compare your salary and get the percent rank? So let's say your salary happens to be 65,000. We want to get the percent rank. Here, we can use the percent rank inclusive. The array is the list of our values, and X this time is our salary. Close bracket, press enter, and we get 78%. If I change this to this value here, so 64,201, we're going to see 75%. We can also write this out and make it dynamic. So basically, this percentage of the people, let's combine this with an and text here that says of salaries are below your salary. Okay, so this is what it means, but we need to make this into a percentage and add a space here. To do that, I'm going to put this in the text function. My value is G10, and I want to format it as a percentage. So in quotation marks, I'm going to put 0%. And quotation mark, close this off, and combine this with this text. We can also show it the other way around, so I'm just going to copy this, paste this here, update the formula to say 1 minus G10, and this percentage of salaries are above your salary. Now we can check if you happen to earn 50,000, 34% of salaries are below your salary. Now, how does this compare to the exclusive version? I'll just write it out here so we can check the different results we get. We have percentile exclusive, This is our array, and K is right here. So let's pull this down, and we can see for the middle value here, we get the same result, but we get different results for the 25th percentile. It's slightly lower, and the 75th percentile is higher than the inclusive version. Now, what is the exclusive version excluding? Well, it's excluding the 0th and the 100th percentile. So if I happen to change this to 0, we're going to get the minimum number back here, whereas we get an error in this case. And if I change this to a 1, we have a similar behavior here where with inclusive, we get the maximum number and we get an error in this case. I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. And it's not just your minimum and maximum number, but your K has to be between 1 divided by N and 1 minus 1 divided by N, where N is the number of values that you have in your data set. Now, which version you use really depends on different factors. It depends on your profession, the type of analysis that you're doing, and also the size of your data set. The one that's most commonly used is the INC version. Okay, so I hope that was clear. Now, the great thing about Excel is that it has all of these extensive functions that we can use. We just have to know what they mean and what they do. Not that we really need all of them, it really depends on your profession. But some functions go across professions. I think the percentile calculation is one of them. Okay, so that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.